Sujit Bharega from JSP Narrative Legal Campus Pune and from Department of Mechanical Engineering. So today we are going to see an experiment related to dynamics of machinery subject. Experiment title is torsional vibration of two rotor system. Okay, so we have to in this experiment we have to compare the frequency, theoretical frequency and calibration frequency, practical frequency with the theoretical frequency of the two rotor system, and we have to find out the position of motor. So firstly, what is the two rotor system? So if we see here, there are, this is the one frame is there and this is the two rotors are there. So if we rotate two rotors in same direction, there is only a rotational motion. But if we rotate these two rotors in opposite direction, then we can say it's a torsional vibration of this two rotor system. So and we can see the, if we move our fingerprints on this, so we can see the vibrations is happening. Okay, so and what is the node point? So node point is point of zero amplitude. So there is no twisting takes place. That location of that point we have to find out from this experiment. So what we have to do first, we have to measure the diameter of shaft, the length of shaft. Okay, so in this diameter and the diameter of this disc, two discs are there here. So let us suppose shaft A, so point O, point A and point B. So this is a disc A having diameter 225 mm, disc B having diameter 150 mm, mass of A, that is its weight is mass is 2.8 kg and here mass is 2.2 kg, and length is 125 mm. So we have to measure this. Okay, so and after this, what we have to see? So we have to view these two discs. If we have to, is clockwise and here, and so we have to rotate these two discs in opposite direction, then only torsional vibration will take place. So for 5 oscillations, how much time is required? That we have to measure the help of stopwatch. Okay, so we have to take such 5 readings, and afterwards we have to calculate the theoretical one. Okay, and we have to compare. So we have to calculate the theoretical time period, and we have to repeat this experiment by attaching these masses. By attaching these masses, of we have 2 masses here, 500 gram and 1000 gram. So we have to apply these 2 masses here on a radial distance from this center point of this disc, and we have to measure this radial distance also. Okay, so let us see the construction or calculation part here. Okay, so as what are the dimensions are here, are properly painted here over this dimension. So let us see the conclusion, calculation part here. So KT is the torsional stiffness of this shaft. Okay, its formula is GIP upon L, G modulus of rigidity is mentioned in this. Mentioned here, so IP polar moment of inertia of the shaft material, and length L is the length of the shaft. Okay, so from this we will come to know KT, torsional thickness of shaft. After that we have to find out the mass moment of inertia. So IA is calculated from MADS square upon A, mass of that disc, diameter of this divided by A. So this is for mass moment of inertia IA. So for IB, for the disc where that load is or that masses, extra masses is attached. So IB is equal to MBDB square upon A, MB mass of this disc B, DB diameter of disc plus this factor. So this W is the weight attached. So first case we have attached 500 gram, so we have to put here 500 gram. R is the radial distance between this center and that mass center. So this is R divided by A. So from this we have to calculate IA, we have to calculate IB. So why? So we have already calculated KT. So by putting these 3 values, KT, IA, IB in this experiment, we will come to know the theoretical frequency. And experimental frequency we have calculated with the help of stopwatch. We have calculated the time period. From time period we have to convert that into frequency, because frequency is the reciprocal of time period. So from this we have to compare these 2 values, theoretical frequency with the experimental frequency. Okay, so it has to be nearer to each other. And then the next part is the location of node point. So if location of node means the point of zero amplitude that we have to find out on the length of the shaft. Okay, so for this LA, so that is the from node point, suppose node point is here. So from node point, distance between node point and rotor is that length with respect to lens. So LA is equal to LIB upon IA plus IB. From this we will come to know the distance between rotor A and node point, that is LA, and we have this formula with us, IA is equal to IBLB, which comes from the derivation. So when we put this LA here, so from this, and we have already calculated IA and IB, and LA we come to know here from this, so we can calculate the LB. So from this we get come to know the distance of both node point, that is LA and LB. So from this we have calculated, compare the natural frequency, theoretical and practical, and also we have calculated the position of node in this experiment. I hope you understand the construction theory procedure of this experiment very well. Okay, thank you.